Hey guys, welcome back to your channel. So it's been a good minute since I've had any content on my Lexus IS300 or my other Lexus IS250. But on today's video, we're gonna be troubleshooting the air conditioning on the IS300 right behind me. Recently, I was driving the car and the air conditioning wasn't working. So on today's video, we'll go through all the little steps to figure out what's wrong with the air conditioning. And then we're gonna go ahead and try to fix it if we can. So stay tuned. All right, so we're looking at the 2JZ right here. So the problem I had was I hadn't driven this car in a couple weeks and I started driving it and I realized the AC wasn't getting cold. It was just blowing ambient air. So I was like, crap, the AC finally gave out on me just because I was expecting it to give out on me just because this thing's a ticking time bomb. If you look at my condenser on here, this thing looks like crap. Everything is all rotted away. All the fins are pretty much torn out and broken, especially down here where it gets all the rock chips. So it's living on the edge with this AC system already, expecting it to fail, and it finally did fail on me. So I had to run some diagnostics because I wasn't sure if it was a leaking refrigerant, bad compressor, or expansion valve. So I actually have these Harbor Freight right here gauges, and I'm gonna go hook them up and I'll show you what the pressures I'm getting. Usually when you have your AC on, the first thing you wanna check is if the clutch is kicking in. So this car, the clutch is actually grabbing and kicking in when I hit the AC button on and off. So I know the clutch works as a magnetic clutch. So those things are pretty reliable. The next thing you wanna do right here on your high pressure valve, there's a little window. If the refrigerant's flowing, you should be able to see it move through that little window. If there's no bubbles and it's a steady stream, then it should be good as far as refrigerant goes from just doing a visual check. So to hook the gauges up, you can see the gauges right there. They clip onto the high pressure and the low pressure. So what you want to do is just go ahead and take off the caps for the high pressure. The low pressure is back here down there by that muffler. Right there, so that's a little bit harder to get to, but you should be able to reach that perfectly fine. Take that cap off. Once you take the cap off, you can see the Schrader valve in there and everything. So make sure you put the caps back on. If you don't have caps, make sure you clean that thing out and put the caps on because you don't want any of the dirt and debris to get into your refrigeration system. So the red is always your high pressure. So this thing has got a little quick release. So you wanna do just put it on there, just make sure it's clamped on. This thing has a screw valve to actually push the Schrader valve. So once you clip it on, make sure it's secure, then you release it or open that up. So do the same right here for the low pressure side. Connect it up. So once you do that, you want to make sure these things are closed because when you open them, they actually go to the yellow and that's for filling the refrigerant. So once you do that, you go ahead and just open the valves up by turning them to the open and you'll hear a little hissing once the thing is pressurized. So you do the same back here. So once it's open, you'll see the pressures on your gauges raise up. So right now, what I'm seeing is 70 and 70 right there, which seems pretty low to me. Because the other day when I did this, it was closer to 100. So we'll see what happens when I start the engine up and see where this thing goes. So now that we got the engine started, you can hear, if I hit the AC off, you can hear the clutch disengage and it re-engages when I hit it on. So right now, what we have around, that's probably 70 PSI. Because if you do 50, that's 75, maybe 80 PSI on the high side. And on the low side, we're at like 55 PSI. So obviously the pressures are incorrect because this one, when the compressor is working, should be up to 200, where this should be down to like 30. So I turned off the clutch and you can see the pressures actually stabilize up to 75 on the low side and about the 75 on the high side. So it's equilibrium right now. And I think these pressures are lower because the other day when I tested this, it was around 90 to 100, but it was also a warmer day. It was probably 80 or 90 out, where today it's like in the 50s, 55. So the ambient temperature affects the refrigerant pressures. Yeah, so I kicked it back on again just to test and you can see Again, this thing's around 55 on the low pressure side and like 80 on the high. That means the compressor's not doing any work right now. If you have high pressure on both sides, it's usually the expansion valve. So again, I shut it off and the gauges basically go back to equilibrium. So they should be equal on both sides right there, which they are. So as far as troubleshooting based on the pressures of the high pressure and the low pressure, if you see this side is too high of a pressure and this side is also high pressure, that means that your compressor is working, but your expansion valve is probably blocked or something else is clogged in the system. Same with your desiccant dryer or other parts of the system. If the pressures are way too high, then that's usually the issue right there. If you plug it up and the gauges don't move much from ambient like mine, it's usually the compressor not doing any work down there. So that's another way to troubleshoot it. There's a couple other ways if you look online to see what the issue is as far as the pressure goes, but it tells you a lot there. One of the things is if your clutch doesn't kick on at all and you show low ambient pressure, that means that there's no refrigerant in the system. Since I do have refrigerant in the system, just at a lower pressure than I had before, that means that this thing does have pressure in it and it's not a leak or anything that's really causing this issue right now. Even if I was low on refrigerant and the compressor kicked on, this number should go up higher than 150 to 200, and then this should drop down, but it won't go down to like 30. It might be down to 40 or 50 if I have low refrigerant. So that's not an issue here on this system. So that's why I came to the conclusion that it was probably the compressor. So I just bought a new used compressor.
Hey guys, thanks for watching all the way to the end of this video on diagnosing this AC compressor and figuring out what's wrong. Go ahead and join me on my future videos as we flush through this system and go ahead and replace all these parts. If you guys haven't subscribed to your channel, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, turn on bell notifications to get notified every time I upload a video. For all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching. I'll talk to you guys next time.